Alright, hello everyone, welcome back to Legend of Mana. It's been a while, but I am SIMSteven, also known as Master Fenrel, and our protagonist is once again a Thalna. Once again, this is kind of the game that kind of got me started on using female protagonists because the male protagonist in this game is freaking ugly. And she looks really awesome. Her character design is just way better than the male character. I think last time we got these two little helpers who we beat the crap out of. but then they decide, hey, you're pretty strong. You'll be my master and all that. So we kind of stopped them from causing trouble back in town. And, well, now they live with us. And we've got a nice big home, so why not? We could use a little bit of company. But anyways, I believe this guy's name is Bud. Study magic at the academy. I've heard of the seven wisdoms of mana. Except one died, so now there are only six. I'm sure I'd like to meet them someday. I wonder where they are. I think he's referring to the spirits in Secret of Mana, the spell system from Secret of Mana. And I think. Well, let's see here. I think we can actually check if we have. I think if we look at some of our equipment, Wisp Shade, so that's light and dark, Dryad Aura, so tree, and wait, did we gain one? I thought there were only eight in the first game. So which one ended up dying? Salamander and Gnome were from Secret of Mana. Jhin and Undyne, I think those were our first four. Aura. I think Aura is actually new. So I think we actually gained one rather than lost one. Anyways, I'm going to take along Lisa because I like her better than Bud anyways. since we now have two party members that are pretty much always available to us from now on, unless we're locked into another side quest or a main quest that requires us to use a certain other one of the other main party members that are out in the world. We're just going to use Lisa for the most part. I'm probably not going to use Bud hardly at all. Maybe I'll use him just to show him off a little bit, but beyond that, I like Lisa better anyways. Anywho, I did do a little bit of playing off screen just to kind of figure out where I'm going to go next. But since it's been like 2 years, or maybe it's been a 1 year, I forget exactly how long it's been since we did those first two episodes, but just kind of do a bit of a recap. Whenever you're on the world map, you can use artifacts to create these locations, like the Mindas Ruins that I'm in now. We first start off at home, then we got an artifact from the Sproutling on our front porch to create Domina, and then we did a quest with the rabbit dude, I believe his name is Niccolo, and we got him through the Luan Highway, and I think from him we got an artifact that allowed us to make the Cat Grottos, or something like that, which we did a side quest for a cat girl, involving some guy with a jewel in his chest who got murdered, and we tried to track down the person who murdered him. And from there, I believe we got an artifact to make these Mindas Ruins. I know there's a quest here in Domina if we go to the inn, but there's an artifact that you get, and you're kind of locked into doing that quest once you start it. And I think I want to place that artifact that we get for that quest, to start that quest. I think I'm going to place it here, and what I need is right here. I need to start going here rather than over here. And what I'm doing is I'm following a guide just for the placement of where I'm putting my artifacts. I'm going to try to avoid following a guide like a full-on walkthrough, because I kind of want to rediscover this game because it's been freaking forever since I played it. I played it a lot back in high school, I think. That's around the time it came out. And I haven't played it hardly ever since. but I do remember doing some co-op with a friend of mine back in high school. And yes, this game does have co-op, very much like Secret of Mana did. And they can actually control secondary party members. Not the third party members, which are basically pets. There's a pet system in this game. But we haven't really unlocked it just yet. But since we just placed this artifact, typically whenever you place an artifact, you actually want to go into that location first. Unless you get the artifact to start at the start of a quest somewhere else, you're pretty much stuck into doing that quest. But yeah, whenever you place a new location that makes a new area, you want to go into that area, because you might just get a quest as soon as you enter, like we did, and I believe it was something to do with tea. Anyways, this guy here, I believe we met him back in Domina, and he's talking about Tipo, who I believe we also met back in Domina. He says he wanted to go off to pick some tea leaves, but we got separated. I hate getting lost. Okay. And there's usually not a ton of dialogue between all the characters. Sometimes there is, but sometimes it's just, hey, here's a quest. Go do it. Anyways, pretty sure I have a two-handed sword equipped. Yes, I do. And it's my favorite type weapon type in the game, so we're gonna just stick with this. And let's do a little combo here. And now that we're actively using a second party member, one who's actually a mage at that, both Lisa and Bud are mages, but these two are spellcasters in particular. You might get party members as you go that are kind of a hybrid. Some are all physical, but Lisa and Bud are definitely spellcasters to the core. And you can kind of see whenever they use a special attack, you can actually see the range of their attacks whenever they start casting them. So the little dome-shaped object that appeared around her when she cast that spell, that's just a spell that you can equip. We can actually equip spells too, but I don't think we have any. And yeah, if you go into your skill menu, you have... Oh, we do have spells. Fire Drum and Fire Harp. Wait, no, that's her. That's Lisa's spells. But anyways, I believe Halo is a spell that, or is an attack that only Lisa gets to use. You can see we're in her stat screen. But we can also equip spells of our own once we are able to, once we find some, that is. Or I think you can actually craft some once you actually are able to start crafting things. But other than that, I'm going to change my skills just a little bit so I can possibly learn some more. I believe weapon skills are based on just kind of a combination of these two abilities. And the more you use these two abilities, the more likely you are to learn skills as you go. Or you just gain some mastery over those abilities to learn more abilities. Anyways, what are you talking about? Something near the four gates does the opening and closing. Key flower links somewhere else work in unison. Remember the formation of the flower links of which the gates they open. Of which they open. Alright, so apparently we might have some puzzle solving to do here. Don't know. But what's off the left here? Some kind of a ruin. Is this kind of like an arena or what? Nothing. Anyways, we're probably going to be doing a lot of this. This game, from what I recall, has a lot of just lots of empty screens, lots of wandering around. So I may end up being lost a lot as we play through. And if you want to, you can save our game at these gold statues. Gold statues is a sprite from Secret of Mana, that is. we're going to take a look around, see if we can find some treasures, see if we can find Tipo, who they just talked about a second ago.
I opened the gates to the underground by psychokinesis. It's tiring.
What? Okay, so he's possibly some kind of gatekeeper. See, like the flower leg that they talked about, that one girl talked about a second ago? I mean, it did look like he had petals for a necklace or something, so probably a plant creature. And yeah, the mana games do have lots of interesting kind of looking characters. So yeah, like Lisa, she could probably be like, I don't know if she's fully grown or if she's just a kid, but you can see she's got long ears. She's kind of an elf.
Yeah, the keys to the gates.
Yeah, the keys to the gates. Okay. So what does this do? I think I kind of remember this. It's, like I said, it's been a long time since I've done anything in this game, so... And I remember these rattlesnake kind of enemies. Remember farming these guys like crazy late in the game. In a later game area. I don't exactly remember what for, but it was some sort of crafting material, if I remember right. Anywho, speaking of stuff you get, notice how we got the crystals and somebody leveled up? I think that might have been me. But it also could have been Lisa a second ago, who got the crystals and leveled up. And that's one thing I'd like to talk about a little bit. Without really spoiling too much, this game does have a new game plus system. So I want to at least mention something about the game's new game plus, at least from what I remember. Yes, it's possible for you to level up your party members. You have to let them, or either you need a second controller and a second player possibly to take control of your extra party members, and they can actually fight for you and level up just like you do. But if I remember right, when you hit New Game Plus, he's opening up a ruin, I guess. That's what the other guy was talking about. If you level up your party members and then hit the New Game Plus after you beat the game, I believe their levels reset. I don't believe your level resets, but I do believe your party members' levels reset. So, it's not really worth letting them get the experience gems that kind of pop out whenever you kill something. So, I kind of recommend just, you know, be an experience hog, grab all the blue gems for yourself, and level yourself up. Don't worry about the secondary party members, don't worry about maxing them out, because, like I said, I think they reset after some point, so... yeah, don't worry about leveling up your party members, it's not worth it. Be an experience hog, be greedy. But anyways, what are these guys doing? I don't really know. But I gotta fight this little chess piece once again. And I believe these were in Secret of Mana as well. I played the remake, or the remaster, about a few months ago, so... I kind of liked the remaster a little bit. They didn't really add anything to the remaster, per se. It's pretty much just a graphical upgrade to the original Secret Mana. And I don't know why it gets as much flack as it does. I thought it was at least a decent remaster. It wasn't exactly a lot of new stuff or anything like that. No dungeons or anything. In fact, I'm pretty sure it's pretty much exactly the same game, just with better graphics. I'm guessing probably what people wanted is they wanted more out of the game than just pretty much just the same game again with better graphics. And I mastered a new technique. Alright, so why don't I equip that since I've got it? Lunging arc. Midrange. They're all mid-range and medium damage. They just probably look different. Anywho, yeah, I don't think the remaster was really all that bad. A lot of people give it crap because... I don't know, maybe they just didn't do much with it? Maybe that's their reasoning, but I don't know. Anywho, what else have we got to do here? I'm kind of getting lost in this maze. So, I don't want to mess with that. I think what the main gimmick is in this place is Well, once we get to a screen, I'll probably talk about it a little bit more. And... well, why don't I, while I'm fighting this guy, and I mentioned these guys before a little bit, enemies kind of level up based on where they're placed on the map in the whole artifact system. So one of the deals with the game's, you know, artifact system is it heavily affects item drops and stuff like, you know, rewards from quests, depending on, you know, how late in the game you are and stuff like that. But definitely, it's definitely worth following a guide so you can maximize the stuff you can get from where you place your artifacts, because, well, getting stuff like pet monsters later is really dependent on mana levels of each area, and you'll find some areas where there's little monster eggs in certain levels, and that allows you to recruit monsters to your little stable, and that's kind of how you're able to you know, get special party members and your little monster friends that you get later. It's definitely worth, you know, getting some of the better monsters, but some of the rarity of certain monsters is heavily dependent on, you know, where you place them on the map. And I'm just kind of fumbling around here, but I think I should really talk about how this gimmick works, because I at least remember how it works now. The placement of those flowers, you kind of notice that they look kind of like the side of a the side of a dice that is, the number 5 on a dice. It's kind of how they're laid out. But there's one on the top, one on the bottom, and one in the middle. The one in the middle summons the other two, and then he's kind of useless after that point. But, that kind of affects the gates that are here. And I haven't actually seen the main gate that those, you know, flowerlings are in. So if I talk to the girls over here and move the bottom one, I should be able to access a different area. I've just kind of been wandering around here aimlessly. And in fact, I don't even know if I'm going the right way. I don't need chocolate if the battle is done. Defensive lunge. I think that's a skill? Anywho, I think we need to go into this screen here. Alright, so here's kind of how the gimmick works. Notice how on the screen with the one flower girl, the upper right and the lower right gates were open, whereas the upper left and lower right gates are open. If we move her over to the left, and it's either left or right, it doesn't really have much different. There's no really. It's pretty much either one or the other, on or off. If you go back to the screen with the little flower girl there, that bottom right gate should now be open, and we should be able to move forward once we get that far. Alright, so once we get back to that screen, we should see... yeah, alright, so we can go down to the right this time. Because when you move the flower girls like that, see how this gate is now locked? Yeah, that's kind of what the gimmick is with how you're able to navigate these ruins. It's kind of a pain because you can't always get to where you need to be. I feel it, I feel it! Okay, so there's entrance over there. And I wonder if this place is just one big circle. Either way, looks like this is the only place we can go, so let's go inside and see what's there. So we're inside. Alright, so we got another one of these chest piece things, like they were in Secret of Mana. Lots of enemies return, if memory serves me right. What do you got? What did you drop? Healing claw. I think that's another material for crafting. Pretty sure it is. A lot of pretty much everything you get in this game, if memory serves me right, is like a material for crafting. And alright, so yeah, I'm kind of getting the feel for these fights back once again. And how you can actually combo like your strong attacks like I've been doing. Kind of like the upward swing, you kind of do like a Hadouken. You roll from down to the left, and you can actually kind of combo all your strong attacks and do a lot more damage than you would normally do just your regular chain attack, which is the X button. Nice experience. Ah, I'm going to take it all for myself. And I got somersault. I think we're getting close to a boss fight, maybe? Well, this kind of looks like a boss fight kind of area. Alright, so what about skills like? Do we learn any new... No. All we're doing right now, it seems, is learning some of just regular abilities you can use regardless of weapon. Dash while defending? That sounds kind of nice. I don't know. Let's do cheer and defenses lunge. I think the way you learn abilities is just do a lot of fights with them equipped, and then eventually stuff will just come to you automatically. Ah, Dwell, where are you? Why don't you come for me? I'm lonely. I feel so bloody, well, bleeding lonely. But spill. All right. So, ooh, boss music. actually one of my favorite boss musics of all time, if memory serves me right. I actually think I got it on my playlist on my YouTube channel for favorite video game music. I believe the title of the song is Pain in the Universe? Why, you're that Ifalma, we've been Domina. Blimey, I went out looking for nasty leaves and got lost. Well, I ended up here, deep underground. And I wonder why Dwell hasn't come for me yet. I fancy that bloke so. Oh, I almost forgot. Oh. Terrible blood-sucking bat that lives here. Do watch out. I'm just letting it go. Well, take care around here. Advance to suck our blood. Okay, whatever. Oh! Transform! What are you, like Dracula? Ah! First I get a magical creature full of water, and now I feel a human. The blood of a peaceful dove can quench my thirst. Well, let's start by disposing of these meddlesome humans. Alright, so it's boss time, and I'm gonna shut up because I love this music, and I'm gonna really get into this fight. We'll be right back. Wait, and that was a bit close. It's down 11% near the end. Anyways, yes, that's the artifact I've been wanting. Because that's where I want to go next on the map. And got another artifact, Rusty Anchor. I don't exactly know where I'm supposed to actually put that, but Bottled Spirit was the one I was looking for. Dwell, oi, why did you come and fetch me? Fetch me some water. you had quite an adventure out there gathering tea leaves, didn't you? Life is full of adventure. Only those who can enjoy it can grow. You're right, but I felt so upless. Oh, scuff. Well, let's go have some tea. Go home and have some tea. Righto. I want to have some tea and forget this old bloody thing. And after another adventure. Oh, dear me. No, thank you. Alright, so little quips is just pretty much all you get out of some of these quests. Others are really about a big story, but I think there's like three major stories within the game. But I think you only really need to complete one of the major stories before you can beat the game. Anywho, yeah, this is the one that I really wanted. Like I said, I was following a guide that tells me where I should put stuff in order to really maximize all the rewards you get from quests and stuff, as well as like monster drops if you want to get some of the more rare materials. You want to play some of the later game, or want to play certain places or certain artifacts in certain areas, like farther away from your home or stuff, just so you can get better drops from the monsters and stuff. Or maybe it's based on like the mana levels, as you can see on the bottom left corner of the screen. Those mana levels are really just the major factor, I think, for a lot of things. Anywho, I'm gonna go home now that we've beaten the quest, and always report to the cactus. And I don't know. I think that's good enough for today. Oh yeah, and whenever you enter your home, whenever you have a secondary party member like Lisa, they go back to wherever you can pick them up normally. I think Niccolo, the one we had for the little highway area before in the previous episode, I think he goes back to Domina where we first met him. Or maybe he goes somewhere else later. My memory's kind of a bit foggy on this. But anyways, we're going to talk to our little cactus. He's like, I like tea. All right, anything else? No. But anywho, what's our journal entry for today? He's going scribble, scribble. All right, so, let's see what he's got to say about today's adventures. Alright, we did that one. We did those quests in previous episodes. Tea time. Well, like, today's adventure was about opening and closing the Flowerling's gates. These monsters can suddenly eat my master's blood. Stop bothering my master. Alright, well, whatever. How many are there? 67 quests in the game. So, there might be a few quests that are kind of unlogged and not actually quests, if memory serves me right. But 67 main quests, and I think there's almost as many artifacts in the game. So maybe just about one or two quests per area, if memory serves me right. But anywho, gonna save our game. And yeah, that little two-player control like I was talking about before. That's if you want to have a friend over and do some co-op. And you get like a second party member like Butter Lisa down below. Anywho, I think that's enough for today. I'm just kind of trying to shake the rust off a little bit today. So doing one quick quest like that today is all I really wanted to do. So thanks for watching, and I will see you guys next time.